The idea that failure is the key to success has emerged as an undeniable fact, and SpaceX has effectively embraced this concept in its quest for incredible accomplishments. In many instances, SpaceX has gone beyond simply learning from its setbacks. The company has actively sought to innovate and improve upon its failures. They proactively seek improvements rather than waiting for failures to occur. Despite its significant successes, SpaceX remains committed to continued redesign, improvement, and rigorous testing in pursuit of the highest levels of reliability for its rockets, with a particular focus on the Starship initiative. Despite having successfully landed 3 Super Heavy boosters, SpaceX has opted to develop an entirely new design for its version 3 booster hardware. Recently, we had the opportunity to take a closer look at these groundbreaking innovations. Let's dive deeper into today's episode of NR Studio. A recently transported component, believed to be the aft section of Starship Block 3, has arrived at the production facility. The exact purpose of this item is still uncertain. However, it can be inferred that it may serve as a prototype or test model designed to assess the structural and thermal characteristics of the aft section of the version 3 Super Heavy booster. The rear of the vehicle is critical as it experiences significant aerodynamic and thermal stress during re-entry and landing. The upper stage of the vehicle requires a robust thermal protection system, TPS, to withstand the intense conditions of hypersonic re-entry. However, it is equally important to ensure that the rear of the booster receives sufficient thermal shielding to protect against the heat generated during its suborbital return, especially around the engine bay. You may recall the inaugural arrestor tower landing of the Super Heavy booster, also known as Booster 12, which was facilitated by the impressive Mecha-Zilla system. A sudden wave of fire engulfed the rear of the booster, followed shortly by a small explosion that compromised the integrity of the surface coating. The incident resulted in significant tearing and structural damage to the section. As a result, Booster 12 was deemed severely damaged and deemed unfit for reuse in future launches. Therefore, it is reasonable to speculate that SpaceX is refining the booster's design to improve landing survivability. We are now witnessing the results of what appears to be an entirely new upgrade, likely serving as a Pathfinder version in anticipation of full-scale production. Observations indicate that Super Heavy version 3 is undergoing testing with a new thermal protection system, TPS, designed specifically for its rear. It's likely that these tiles are made of stainless steel, encasing a specially designed re-entry tile material. This is a significant departure from previous booster designs that reportedly used engine shields to protect the rear. Stainless steel is a defining feature of SpaceX's Starship initiative, chosen for its impressive properties, including a high melting point of about 1,510 degrees Celsius for standard alloys. Not only is the material tough, it also offers a cost-effective alternative to conventional materials like aluminum, lithium, or carbon fiber. After examining some publicly available images, the hexagonal heat shield tiles exhibit an incredible level of sharpness and excellent workmanship. Many have theorized that the production of these tiles involved water jet cutting, a method consistent with standard industry practice. Water jet technology stands out as the optimal solution for achieving precision cuts in metals, such as stainless steel. This method produces smooth, clean edges while minimizing the risk of thermal distortion. The cutting tool uses high-pressure water combined with an abrasive to easily cut through materials several inches thick. This capability makes it ideal for creating intricate tile designs. Furthermore, it appears that the stainless steel tiles are positioned around a specially designed re-entry tile material, indicating the use of a composite thermal protection system, TPS, in the design. This may include the use of ceramic or silica-based materials, similar to those used in the Space Shuttle Thermal Protection System, TPS, as well as the tiles found on the Starship windward side. These materials are engineered to withstand extreme temperatures that reach as high as 1,260 degrees Celsius. The special re-entry tile material has the potential to feature a lightweight design with high emissivity properties, allowing it to dissipate heat effectively. Meanwhile, the incorporation of stainless steel offers significant structural reinforcement and increases resistance to oxidation. This multi-layered technique has the potential to reduce weight compared to traditional solid ceramic tiles, while ensuring efficient thermal insulation remains intact. However, that's not the only interesting thing. There's another interesting detail worth noting. Each hexagonal tile is designed with a pair of countersunk holes. You may have seen them before. What's their purpose? We invite you to share your insights in the comments section below. This is one theory I've explored. The presence of these countersunk points suggests a potential mounting mechanism for the tiles. They are similar to retainers that have countersunk holes. The retainers act as spacers that raise the tile above the booster surface. This design could create an air gap, which could improve insulation or allow for thermal expansion. The concave holes indicate that the fasteners, such as bolts or screws, are designed to be flush with the tile surface. This feature helps reduce aerodynamic drag and minimizes heat concentration. This configuration provides optimal retaining pressure across the hexagonal design, indicating a focus on a robust assembly that can withstand the mechanical stresses encountered during launch, re-entry, and landing. Hexagonal tiles have gained popularity in thermal protection system, TPS designs, particularly on the windward side of Starship. This shape is favored for its efficient tessellation properties, which help reduce gaps and improve thermal distribution. The latest developments are certainly exciting, but it's important to remember that we'll ultimately need to receive official confirmation from SpaceX before drawing any conclusions. This is likely to happen in the near future, as SpaceX will need to confirm the efficacy of the new design before moving forward with changes to all of their super heavy prototypes. In recent times, SpaceX has demonstrated its unwavering commitment to advancing the Starship program through various developments. The booster will require a full-fledged heat shield for its entire rear section, not just a few engines. The removal of the outdated shields demonstrates SpaceX's confidence in its new thermal protection system, TPS's ability to effectively manage thermal loads. This development could result in a more streamlined design and overall weight reduction. This aligns with SpaceX's goal of reducing repair requirements between missions. A long-life thermal protection system, TPS, could potentially eliminate the need for extensive, maintenance-intensive shielding. The newly developed TPS has been specifically engineered to protect the Raptor engines and their associated fuel systems. During re-entry, the booster experiences aerodynamic heating, which is relatively mild compared to the upper stage. This reduced heating occurs because the booster is traveling at a lower speed, roughly between Mach 8 and 9. The thermal protection system, TPS, is designed to maintain temperatures within a safe range for its stainless steel frame and fragile components. This capability is critical to enabling rapid reusability, a fundamental aspect of SpaceX's goal of achieving operational efficiencies similar to commercial airlines. The testing of this innovative heat shield not only met its primary goal, but also opens the door for SpaceX to develop more advanced thermal protection system, TPS designs. This could lead to the creation of new thermal protection strategies specifically for the Starship upper stage, allowing it to withstand the intense conditions of re-entry into Earth's atmosphere. Thermal protection continues to present a significant challenge, as neither SpaceX nor other aerospace companies have yet to perfect the balance between optimal spacecraft protection and rapid reusability. A groundbreaking concept has recently emerged that could revolutionize the future of space exploration. In an exciting collaboration, researchers from Texas A&M University have teamed up with Canopy Aerospace to create an innovative 3D printed material designed to protect spacecraft during intense re-entry into Earth's atmosphere. The innovative material has the unique ability to release a cooling gas, effectively helping to manage the extreme heat encountered during descent. This groundbreaking technology is called transpiration cooling. Re-entry into Earth's atmosphere is one of the most challenging stages in space travel. As spacecraft descend into the atmosphere at hypersonic speeds, often exceeding 7.5 kilometers per second, or about 16,800 miles per hour, they encounter tremendous friction along with the compression of the surrounding atmospheric gases. This process produces temperatures that can exceed 2,000 degrees Celsius, 3,600 degrees Fahrenheit, reaching levels intense enough to melt most standard materials. To withstand the dangerous heat of re-entry, spacecraft have traditionally relied on thermal protection systems, TPS. These include ablative heat shields designed to scorch and erode during re-entry, as well as ceramic tiles, similar to those used on the space shuttle. The latter require careful inspection and replacement after each mission to ensure optimal protection. While these systems have proven effective, they tend to be designed for single use or require significant manual effort to maintain. This makes it difficult to achieve rapid and cost-effective reuse of spacecraft. The transpiration cooling method, innovatively created by Texas A&M University in collaboration with Canopy Aerospace, presents an innovative solution. It uses a uniquely designed material that releases a cooling gas through its permeable frame during reentry. The gas comes from the spacecraft's surface, creating a protective layer that serves two important roles. The material effectively cools itself by absorbing and dissipating heat, while also acting as an insulating barrier. This barrier is crucial in preventing the intense heat of the atmosphere from coming into direct contact with the spacecraft's surface. This gas-based insulation is inspired by a common occurrence in our daily lives. According to Hassan Saad Ifti, assistant professor of aerospace engineering at Texas A&M University, gases exhibit very low thermal conductivity. The effectiveness of the layer jacket can be attributed to a few key factors. The design of the jacket has pockets that trap air, which acts as insulation. It is this trapped air that provides warmth, not the solid material of the jacket itself. In a similar context, the cooling gas emitted by a spacecraft forms a low conductivity barrier, greatly reducing thermal stress on the vehicle. At the heart of this innovative development is an advanced material created by Canopy Aerospace, which features a 3D printed silicon carbide composite. Silicon carbide has gained recognition for its exceptional strength and exceptional heat resistance, positioning it as a top choice for applications in the aerospace industry. One of the distinguishing features of this material is its carefully engineered porosity, which allows the cooling gas to flow and evaporate through tiny channels at a microscopic level. This permeable framework needs to strike a delicate balance. The material must be strong enough to withstand the intense aerodynamic forces and thermal stresses encountered during reentry, while also being permeable enough to facilitate effective coolant release. To assess the effectiveness of this innovative material, researchers at Texas A&M University conducted a comprehensive evaluation in a carefully controlled setting that replicated the intense conditions experienced during reentry. The experiment centered on two key metrics: the material's ability to consistently emit coolant gas and the efficiency of the gas layer in providing insulation for the spacecraft. William Matthews, a fourth-year PhD candidate who spearheaded the testing initiative, noted that we can expect the material surface to maintain a lower temperature at hypersonic speeds when a coolant flow is applied, as opposed to a baseline scenario where no coolant is used. The evaluation consisted of exposing prototype samples to rapid airflow and extreme temperatures, effectively simulating the hypersonic environment experienced during reentry. The researchers were able to evaluate the cooling effects and analyze the insulating properties of the gas layer by comparing the material's performance when the coolant flow was present versus when it was absent. Initial findings appear encouraging. However, the research team is investigating a variety of factors. These factors include the type of coolant used, the rate of outgassing, and the porosity of the material, all in an effort to improve the overall performance of the system. Transpiration cooling systems offer a number of important benefits over traditional thermal protection systems, TPS. First, they eliminate the need for ablative heat shields, which can be damaged upon reentry and require replacement before each mission. Additionally, they avoid the maintenance challenges associated with ceramic tiles, which are prone to damage and require extensive inspection and repair before each flight. In contrast, spacecraft utilizing transpiration cooling technology have the potential to land, refuel, and take off again with minimal downtime. This capability can significantly reduce the cost and complexity associated with space missions. Additionally, the reusability of the system supports the larger movement towards sustainable and economically viable space exploration. Companies such as SpaceX and Blue Origin have demonstrated the benefits of reusable rocket technology. However, achieving a fully reusable spacecraft designed for regular orbital missions continues to be a critical goal in the aerospace industry. However, many obstacles still need to be overcome before this technology can be used in a functioning spacecraft. The team expressed a positive outlook on the potential of the technology. However, as Matthew noted, the effectiveness of gas permeation through the material plays a critical role in determining the range of possible outcomes for this innovation. Upcoming testing is anticipated to provide valuable insights, guiding the team in choosing the best course of action. The current experiment is critical in providing key insights that will direct the trajectory of fully reusable spacecraft development. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next episode, and thank you for your support.